Today, we're going to be taking a look at Adobe's Premiere Rush video editor for iOS and Android devices. So whether you have an iPhone, iPad, or the latest Android phone or tablet, you can take advantage of the many advanced video editing features available in this incredible app. You can download Premiere Rush for free from the App Store or Google Play, and all you'll need to do is to create a free Adobe account to access most of the features of the app that I'm going to show you today. You can use it for free as long as you want with unlimited exports, or you can upgrade to access all of the premium features and hundreds of soundtracks, sound effects, loops, animated titles, overlays, and graphics. Whether you go for the free version or the premium, Premiere Rush will allow you to add music and titles to your videos, apply video effects to the clips in your multi-track timeline, trim, adjust speed, enhance color, and you can even crop your videos to suit social media formats, including 16:9 horizontal, square, and 9:16 portrait modes. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to edit videos incorporating photos, videos, text, and music on the timeline. So without any further delay, let's go ahead and learn how to use Adobe Premiere Rush. To create your first project, simply tap on the plus button icon at the bottom of the screen. Here you'll be presented with two options: one, add media, and two, take video or photo. So if you're going to do a quick vlog and you want to record and edit right away, you could tap on the second option. But if you already shot some footage and photos and you want to combine them all into a project, then tap on the add media option, which is the one that we're going to be showing you today. You can now go in and select the media that you wish to use in your project. Don't worry if you miss a few, you can always add them once you're inside the edit at a later stage. But for now, I'll start by adding a good 5 or 6 clips of video and some photos into the project so that we can get a good start. So once you've made those selections, tap on add. And if this is the first time you've used the app, you'll probably get a message box appearing on screen asking for permission to access your photo library. Say yes to this and Premiere Rush will begin preparing your media for use in the project. This can take a few minutes, especially if you have large video files, so be patient, and you'll then end up on the main editing screen of the app. At the top is the preview window where you can see the changes that you make as you're editing, and below that, under the controls, you can swipe along over the thumbnails that you just imported to get to any point on the timeline and edit. All of those video clips and photos will appear in sequence and most likely will not be in the order that you want for your project. So the first thing that I tend to do is to arrange my clips in the right order. You can pinch the thumbnail timeline to contract and expand, and to move a clip into the right position, simply tap on it, hold for a moment, lift up, and move it left or right. And then once it's in the right spot, let go of the clip and it will be placed to that point in the timeline. Keep doing this until you have all of your clips where you want them in the right order on the timeline. Now, before we go any further and start getting into the edit, I'm going to tap on the crop tool, which is the fourth icon in the menu at the base of the screen. This allows us to change the crop and aspect ratio of the project. So depending on where you're sharing your video, you need to choose the right format. If you're uploading to YouTube, the default 16:9 horizontal crop is the way to go. So just leave it as is. If you're going to TikTok or Instagram TV, select the next option, which is 9:16 vertical or portrait format. If you want your video to be displayed on the Instagram timeline or even Facebook, you could select any of these options, but for optimal viewing, you can go for the 4:5 or 1:1, which is equivalent to a square format. So for this example, I'm going to use the 9:16 vertical crop and create a portrait mode video for Instagram TV. Because I've selected this crop, some of my clips, which were originally shot in widescreen format, may need to be repositioned. So to do that, navigate to those clips by tapping on them in the timeline. Tap on the thumbnail of the clip and you'll see a blue crop box appear around the clip in the video preview window tab. Tap your finger anywhere on screen and move left or right You can even pinch to zoom in and out of the footage and even twist and rotate it. The next thing we need to do is some basic cutting of our video clips. To do that, tap on the clip you want to edit in the timeline and it will be highlighted in orange with two large handles on the left and right hand side of the clip. Tap on the handle on either side to contract the clip inwards, adjusting the in point and out point of the video clip. You can swipe left along the bottom menu icons to reveal some additional tools for editing. There's the scissors tool, which allows you to cut clips. To do that, move the playhead in the timeline to any point over the video clip that you want to cut and tap on the scissors tool to make that cut. If you tap on the plus icon next to the scissors tool, you can duplicate the movie clip on the timeline. And next to that is the trash icon, which allows you to delete clips from your project. The next thing we're going to do is add a transition effect between our clips. To do this, tap on the first clip and then tap on the effects icon at the base of the screen. When you do this, you'll see a list of transitions you can apply between the clips. They range from a standard dissolve, fade to black, fade to white, wipe left, wipe right, up, down, slide and push left, right, and up and down. You can also adjust the duration of the transition by tapping on the duration icon below and moving the slider left and right. While we're here in effects, let's take a look at the motion tab. Here, you'll see two options, pan and zoom, which is automatically applied to photos that are added to your project. So rather than sitting still, they are animated on the timeline. So if you added a photo and you want to take that effect off, this is where you can do that. This effect only works on photos, so it'll be grayed out as it is now when you're in a video. The next option is auto reframe, but this is only available on the upgrade to the premium version of Premiere Rush. Smart reframe will automatically reframe your footage and keep the focal point of the main object in your scene right in the middle. So this is ideal for those of you cropping 16:9 widescreen video clips into the 9:16 portrait orientation. I'm gonna tap on the small arrow on the bottom left to exit the effects section, and now we're back on the main edit window. Let's try adding some graphics to the project. To do that, simply tap on the graphics tab and then add graphics. The section is divided into three. At the top, there are titles. Below that are transition graphics, and below that are the overlays. You can swipe along with your finger left and right to reveal all available options in each of these sections. In the title section, you get quite a few to choose from. You can try by tapping a few and then adding them to your timeline. You'll notice that the titles are added as a new layer above your video or photo. If you decide you want to remove any, just tap on the layer and hold, then release and select the delete option. Once added to the timeline, I can move it along left or right by tapping on the type layer and moving the clip into the right position. And if you notice below, there are a range of options that allows us to change the layout, type, style, and font. There are so many options here to choose from, so you'll need to spend a little bit of time working out which one looks best with your video or photos on the timeline. The transition graphics are great for spicing up your edit. Some of these are included with the free version, but you'll notice that others are only available in the demo mode and can be unlocked with the purchase of the full paid version of Premiere Rush. And finally, in the effects section is the overlay option. There's a subscribe animation button, which is great for YouTubers, hearts animation, a Polaroid photo frame, swipe up animations, loading content stars, and even a numeric counter. Not a huge amount of options here, but certainly a few that you might find useful. A few more things before we wrap it up. Let's tap on the third icon at the bottom to reveal all layers in the project. This is great for adding clips on top of one another, for example, in a picture-in-picture or split screen style. So for example, I'll tap on the plus button icon and add a photo on top of this video clip here. By default, the photo that I just added will go onto layer one next to the video clip. Now, all I have to do to layer it on top of the video clip is to tap and hold and lift it up into position. Then tap on the clip and pinch and zoom in and out.
I now have two clips as layers on the timeline in picture-in-picture fashion. For split screen, just expand and position accordingly. Remember, in the previous section, I mentioned the pan and zoom effect gets applied automatically. Now we have to go into the effects section and turn it off in order to avoid having that picture-in-picture screen animating. Let's take a quick look at audio. To separate the audio track from the video, tap and hold the video clip. Tap on the separate audio and the audio track will appear in the audio section below. Now you can drag it independently of the video clip or mute it by tapping on the mute icon in the timeline. Tap on the audio clip to make sure it's highlighted and swipe left along the bottom menu to reveal the additional tools. Tap on the audio icon, tap on clip volume, and now you can adjust the level of the audio for each of the clips on your timeline. You can also use the mute icon in this section to mute the track. If you upgrade to the premium version, you can use the next two icons to have Premiere Rush automatically adjust your volume. So you can set the type of audio, either vocal or music, for all of the clips on your timeline, and then tap on auto volume and Premiere Rush will automatically ramp the volume up and down to make sure your vocals stand out in the mix. If you want to record a voiceover track or any type of audio into the timeline, just tap on an empty layer in the audio track section, tap on the microphone and start recording. To add some music to your project, tap on the plus button, tap on audio and scroll through the list. There are only a few basic music tracks and sound effects in the free version. To get access to the full library, you can upgrade to the paid version, which is available on a monthly or yearly subscription fee, starting at $7.99 per month or $56.99 per year if you commit to the 12-month plan. If you have one of your own audio tracks to import, you can do that too. Simply tap on the plus button again, tap on media and locate your audio file. If you want to learn how to bring in audio tracks onto your iPhone so that they're available to use right here in Premiere Rush or any other apps like iMovie, I've created a video on how to do that and I'll leave a link in the description box below. Next, we're going to take a look at color. If you tap on the color icon, you can choose from a range of filters to add style to each of your video clips. And below these preset filters, you can use the exposure, contrast, highlight, shadow, and tint sliders for exact control over the color and mood of your photos and videos in the project. Finally, you can adjust the speed of a video clip by tapping on the speed icon bottom right of the screen. Just tap on the range speed menu item and adjust the slider up or down to slow down or speed up the clip. As you do this, you'll notice the video clip will expand and contract on the timeline. You can tap on the play button in the preview window to monitor the changes. And once you're happy with the speed, tap on the back button arrow on the bottom left and your changes will be applied. So that's all I wanted to show you in terms of the features of Premiere Rush. The only thing left to look at is how to export your video out so that you can share it. To do this, tap on the export icon, which is at the top right-hand corner of the screen. Tap on the quality settings and select the desired resolution. Tap on export and your video will start rendering. And once complete, the video will be saved directly to your camera roll. And you then get to the next screen, which lets you share to Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, or Behance directly from within the app.
Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial on how to use Premiere Rush. If you did, feel free to hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel so that you're notified of up and coming video releases. See you on the next one. Bye for now.